चलिए गाइस, सो वील स्टार्ट वे विद टुडेज लेक्चर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 12 एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर 13 वी ऑल हैड डन. ऑन द सिमिलर लाइंस वी हैड अ क्वेश्चन नंबर 14. ऑब्वियसली क्वांटिटी प्रोड्यूस क्वांटिटी सोल्ड इज ऑल गोइंग टू बी रिमेनिंग सेम ओनली. डायरेक्ट मटेरियल, डायरेक्ट लेबर, फिक्स फैक्ट्री ओवरहेड्स, वेरिएबल फैक्ट्री ओवरहेड्स एंड योर प्रॉफिट फॉर द ईयर इन एनी केस इज गोइंग टू बी सेम ओनली. सो ऑल दोस थिंग्स वी ऑल हैव रिटन. ओके, what is left are two things and these are the same two things that I told you all to try at home. Okay, so first answer, if somebody has tried it at home, okay, I want the answer of direct labor. Tell me what is the answer for direct labor if somebody has tried it at home. I'm looking forward for the answers, please.
90,000.
And for semi-variable overheads? 60,000. 60 or 65? Okay, one person says a 60, one person says a 65. Okay. Let's start it off with direct labor. Now, direct labor, it is 2 per unit, but subject to minimum of 6,000 per month. Now, we have guaranteed a worker that we are going to be paying you minimum 6,000 per month. That is not same as 72,000 per annum because now you are going to be doing the calculations on month by month basis. Okay. So I'm going to be doing the calculations separately for all the months, but let me not do it separately for all the months because first 3 months we are operating at 50%. Okay. Last 9 months we are operating at 80%. So we can do the calculations for the first 3 months. Whatever is applicable for the first month will also be applicable for the next 2 months. Whatever is applicable for the fourth month will also be applicable for the next 8 months. Is this language understood by everybody? Because the everybody can reply, please. Is this understood by everybody?
Yes, sir.
So what I'm going to be doing, very simple thing. You are going to be paying rupees 2 per unit for each and every unit that the workers will produce. So let me count that in the first month, how many units you are going to be producing. How many units you will produce, I'll multiply that thing by rupees 2. I'll compare that particular amount with, continue. I'll compare that amount with, please continue.
6,000 rupees per month.
And tell me, do I need to add both the figures?
No.
No, we will be taking whatever is higher. Is that all okay?
Yes.
Okay, so let me start to be doing direct labor. I'm just asking all, do I need to read the question for the third time? Do I need to be reading the question? You all remember the question, no?
Yes,
okay, fine it is. Okay, so you all write down your working note 1, please. Write down. Working note 1, direct labor. First 3 months. Production, I'm writing per month. So 7,500 is obviously for 3 months. We divided by 3, 2,500 into wage rate. So for every unit, we are supposed to be paying them $2. So therefore 5,000. So if I talk of only 1 month, if I talk of only 1 month, based upon the number of units, those guys are supposed to be getting 5,000 rupees from us. But we have guaranteed them how much? 6,000. So therefore, you all write down minimum or guaranteed wages. 6,000. Higher of above. Put that on extreme right hand side. No, put that in the inner column only. Into, write down number of months. 18,000. Please exactly do the same thing for the last 9 months. Obviously, numbers are going to be different. Please start.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
So I got disconnected. Please repeat the question, please.
In last 9 months, in every month, we are going to be producing 4,000. Into wage rate. So therefore, just a sec, 8,000. But minimum or guaranteed wages is 6,000. So do I pay them 14,000?
No.
No, we pay them whatever is higher, no? So therefore higher.
8,000.
You're going to be paying them 8,000. So therefore 8,000 into number of months. 72,000. So one is 18 for the first 3 months, then it becomes 72 for the last 9 months. So therefore, in all, that will become 90,000. Then further. Now, do one thing. So, put 90,000 over here. 90,000 divided by 43,500. So, therefore, it will become 2.07. 5.07. 220,500. $7,500 comes from here, $36,000 comes from here. This is a production. I'm talking of the production only, but per month. Now, your working note 1 is altogether done. Okay. Second thing in this particular case is obviously your semi-variable. Now, those people who have got it and I have confirmed that it is correct, so it is all correct. For those people who have not got it, okay, I give you 2 minutes now. Read this sentence properly. Obviously, it is different as compared to our yesterday's question. And try to think of the answer. Obviously, there are few words to be cracked and those are these particular words, which I have done in bold. So, do read that. Try to work out the answer. This is the only thing to be thought of. One minute more, I'm giving it to you. Okay. Answer now. Those people who might confirm it's a correct answer, forget it. For those people who have not confirmed, what's the correct answer? Let's not have a mute batch. This is the third question we are doing, almost the same numbers. Your senses should have increased by now. $65,000 is not the correct answer. Interpret those only words that had to be done.
$67,500,
that's wrong. Another answer. Now everybody is going to be saying sorry. Say sorry, everybody. Say sorry, only then I'll try to say the correct answer. Say sorry.
Sorry.
Tell one more line. We will use our brains from the next time. You speak that sentence, then I'll start. We'll use our brains from the next time. I should be able to hear it. Okay, cartoons, now listen. Now those guys are saying ₹50,000 per annum up to 50% capacity and an extra expense of ₹10,000 for every 25% increase in capacity or part thereof for the year as a whole. So now those guys do not want this thing, 50% in the first 3 months and 80% for the next 9 months. They don't want this particular thing. They want a single capacity which will be applicable for the year as a whole. Can we say in the entire year you are producing how many units? You tell me that number, please. 43,500. Can we say our 100% capacity, 60,000, no? You take your calci, 43,500 divided by 60,000 percentage. So therefore, your percentage capacity for the year as a whole is 72.5%. Is that all okay? So this sentence, once you read, you should have got that 72.5%. Okay, so let me first of all compute that 72.5% and then we shall continue. Write down please, working note 2. Capacity utilization for the year as a whole. Is equal to 43,500 divided by 60,000 into 100 is equal to 72.5%. Now I can tell you another way, but then I'll only tell you, you might not be writing that particular thing. Obviously, if you will be doing average of 50 and 80%, no, that should be coming to 72.5% only, but average always means weighted average. And for weighted average, of course, for weighted average, obviously, I'll be requiring weights. Okay, and there's only one thing that can act as weights, and that is nothing but time duration. So, you all know how to find out the weighted average? I'm just asking. You all have found out weighted average, net profit and all in the chapter of goodwill and all, no?
Yes.
Okay, so your weighted average, now 50% is going to be happening for how many months? 3 months. And 80% is going to be happening for how many months? 12 months. You all do one thing. For weighted average, what is our next step? What we all should do? We all should multiply these particular two things, no?
Yes.
So you multiply this. This will be coming to 150. This will be coming to 720. You total it up. This particular thing will be coming to how much? 870. Take your calci, do 870 upon 12, please. 72. So 72.5. You could have done like that also. So in any case, we all have done by one method. That's enough. Okay, listen up. So now, what are you going to be thinking? Forget about that 50%. Forget about that 80%. For semi-variable overheads, try to be thinking only one thing, that you are working at 72.5% for the year as a whole. Okay, now I give you 20 seconds only. Read this sentence again. and think you are operating at 72.5% for the entire year. You require maximum actually 5 seconds to answer. Tell me what will be your semi-variable overheads. Are you all understood 60,000 how?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Up to 50% your cost will be how much?
50,000.
And whether you go from 50 to 72.5 or you go from 50 to 70, can we say in any case you will have to incur how much rupees extra? 10,000. Is that all okay for everybody? So answer is going to be 60,000. And now I think so you all will understand. Even if this was 10,000 per annum, no, answer will still be 60,000 only. Because you are going to be operating at 72.5% for the entire year, no. So in this particular question, even if it was 10,000 rupees per annum, answer would have remained same because this 72.5 is your percentage utilization for the year as a whole. Is this understood?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt? Okay. So we are finding out our semi-variable overheads right now. So up to 50%, plus extra expense of ₹10,000 to increase capacity from 50% to 72.5%. Put this figure as part of your cost sheet, semi-variable overheads. Fetch your answer, please. You can tell me the selling price once you get it.
Sir, 17.19.
I don't know. Whatever you'll say, I'll accept it.
17.19.
Just everybody can confirm, please. Now, since yesterday we all have done three questions, towards the end of this question, I have the summary of all the three questions. In case of semi-variable cost, we have done three cases above. In case per annum word is not there, do not do time proportionate. It is a flat cost. This was your question number 12. You can write it. In case per annum word is there, do the cost time proportionate. It is not a flat cost. That was question number 13. In case words are for the year as a whole, first find out the capacity utilization for the year as a whole. And then whether it is per annum or not, answer will remain same. That is exact thing that I told you all. This was your question number 14. Okay. For labor, if minimum wages contract is there, wages to be paid will be higher as per the plan, means at the rate of 2 per unit, or minimum wages, whatever is higher. Okay, so we did exactly the same particular thing. Okay, so your these three types of questions that in your module are there in this particular chapter, that's chapter number 8 in your module. Okay, all those three questions are altogether done. Okay, so 15th and 16th are based upon that only. Leave two sides for question number 15. Leave two sides for question number 16. So in all, you're leaving four sides, and then you're coming to question number 17, please. Now, read question number 17. A re-roller produced 400 metric tons of MS bars. Re-roller is kind of a machine, okay? So, a re-roller produced 400 metric tons of MS bars. Spending, MS bars should be steel bars or something like that, okay? Spending 36 lakh rupees towards material and 6 lakh 20,000 rupees towards rolling charges. Okay. 10% of the output, now this is important for me, 10% of the output was found to be defective, which had to be sold at 10% less the price for good production. So what these guys are saying, out of the total output, 10% is defective. Tell me what was supposed to be the total output. What was the total output? 400 metric tons. Out of 400 metric tons, 10% is defective. Okay. But even if it is defective though, it is sold in the market but at a lower price. And that lower price is 10% lesser than the good production. Can we say good production is going to be 360 tons? Okay, because 10% is supposed to be the defective one. Okay. If the sales realization should give the firm an overall profit of 12.5% on cost. So this much is a profit that we want. Find the selling price per metric ton of both the categories of bars. Okay. Tell me both the categories of bars means? Good and defective ones. Okay. Further. The scrap arising during the rolling process fetched a realization of 60,000. Now, one small thing. See, whenever you're going to be doing the production, no, some amount of scrap will of course be coming out. Now, in your cost sheet, no, there is a special place where scrap comes. But I'm not trying to be dealing with that particular thing right now. That I will be dealing in some chapter called as process costing. Okay. But whatever might happen, can we say, if suppose you can sell the scrap and get income out of it, everybody would like to be doing it, right? Okay, that income no is not your normal sales. Okay, that income is not your normal sales. But our sales is of goods. Okay, this is of scrap. So whatever scrap value you get by selling scrap, no, that should be reduced from your cost, because ultimately that will go to reduce your cost. Okay. So it is not sales for you, it is reduction of cost. Although both of them exactly mean the same particular thing only, but it is always better to be reducing in this particular case the scrap value from the cost only. And whenever we are going to be doing a process costing and advanced cost sheet, that time there is a special place that from which cost sale of scrap should get reduced. That I will tell you in those particular chapters, not right now. But in this question, no, there are no stocks as such. If there are no stocks, you reduce it from any cost. Ultimately, answer will come same. You will be remembering one line that I told you all yesterday also. If there are no stocks, format of cost sheet is bloody damn useless, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so it does not matter to us, at least for this particular question. Okay, so let us start. Now, we have to be finding out two selling prices. One is for the normal goods and the other particular thing is for the defective goods. Okay. But apart from these two, there is scrap. That scrap, once it is sold, gives me a realization of 60,000. Okay. Now, what I'm trying to be doing, I'm trying to find out the output of good units and output of the defective units. That in any case, we all know out of 440 is defective, so 360 is normal. But I'm writing down those particular things. You all write down? Question number 17. Total output 400 metric tons. Now, normal goods, defective goods, So this is 40 tons, this is 360 tons. Okay, tell me one thing, what is the aim of this question? What I have to try to find out? What is the aim of this particular question? Please read it and try to tell me. Selling price. Can we say, if I take this selling price of these goods to be X, selling price of these goods will be 10% lower, means 0.9X. Is that okay? Okay, so therefore into selling price X, this particular thing will be 0.9X, that is 10% lower. So therefore, if I multiply these particular two things, it will give me sales 360X, 36X. Total sales of the company will be 396X. Let the output of, sorry, let the selling price of normal goods be X. Therefore, selling price of defective goods will be 0.9X. Now see, I'm going to be doing a very simple job after this. This is supposed to be the sales. But can we say sales can also be calculated as cost plus profit? In this question, try to tell me that there are two costs which are given to you. Tell me the name of those particular two costs, please. One is your material, the second one is? I want exact name, whatever is printed to you in the book, please. The second name is?
Rolling charges.
The rolling charges, okay. But these costs will be falling because of one reason also. What is that particular reason? I'll have to reduce something from these particular costs. I just now spoke, yaar. Scrap value. So let me try to be finding out the cost as such, and the profit margin is given to you in the question itself. Okay. So therefore, you all write down calculation of cost and sales. So material 36 lakhs. Rolling charges 620,000. Less scrap 60,000. Whatever you reduce, please put that figure in brackets, please. This is your cost. So 36 lakhs, 41,60,000. And profit. In the question, what's the profit percentage that we are looking at?
12.5%
on cost. On cost, no? So we already have our cost. So 12.5% on cost. 520,000. So we got to be having this much amount of sales. 46,80,000. And almost my last words, can we say this much sales we are going to be having by selling two types of goods, no? One is your normal goods, other is your defective goods. Is that all okay?
Yes.
Okay. And I think from defective goods, we will get this much. From normal goods, we are going to be getting this much. So therefore, in all, we all are going to be getting this much. Can you say this 396X is nothing but this particular figure, no?
Yes.
both of them are sales only, no, yaar, as such. Okay, so therefore, 396x is equal to 46,80,000. Please find out x, then find out 0.9x also, because we want the selling price of both the categories of bars. So 46,80,000 divided by 396. 11,818.20. 11,818. I'll write down 0.18 only. That'll be better. Okay, and this is 0.9x. Please multiply above answer by 0.9, please.
10,636.36.
Job done. Listen, just one thing from this particular question, it was quite a simple one. If there are two products with different selling prices and cost cannot be calculated separately, then make the equation and compute the selling prices. So that is what we all have done. Now in this question, no, we cannot find out separate cost for these type of goods or for these type of goods. It was a combined cost only. Just that the selling prices had to be different. So therefore, in end, we make the equation and we try to come across the answer. Okay. Now, our last two questions to finish off this chapter. Okay. Cost sheet on multiple products. Now, what do you mean by this? Obviously, there will be a lot of companies in this world who manufacture more than one product. Okay. In fact, 99% of all the companies today who manufacture something manufacture more than one product. You talk of any company, say Apple, they all manufacture phones, say tablets, say AirPods, say Macintosh. Okay, there are so many things that these guys make. In iPhone also, they'll be having so many categories of phones that these guys will be making. Okay, so our purpose in the next two questions is very simple. Let's try to make cost sheets products wise. Okay, so therefore, if there are two products, I like to make separate cost sheet for product A, separate cost sheet for product B. So, sir, what is tough in that? One thing that is tough, they will give you common expenses and you will have to try to bifurcate those particular expenses as such. And that is what we are going to be doing. So, I have one sample question for it. This is question number 18. Okay, this is my question. I usually call such questions as concept builder questions, which I have created myself to strengthen your concepts. Okay, and then based upon this, we are going to be doing question number 19. Okay, so let's do question number 18, please. Okay. A company produces product A and product B. One unit of A will require 8 kgs, while one unit of B will require 10 kgs of material. Okay. 1 kg of raw material for product A costs rupees 6, while 1 kg of raw material for product B will be costing rupees 8. Okay. The company produced 100 units of product A and 150 units of product B. Find material cost for the period for the company. This question is only put forward for some particular concept. Okay. Now you all do one thing. I give you 2 minutes on your screen. You get me total direct material cost for product A and for product B combined. I want combined figure. Okay. Get me the answer on your calci. No writing anything, please. ऑल आंसर्स आर करेक्ट ओनली वट एवर यू ऑल आर गिविंग. आप लोग बस सब लोग मेरे को आंसर बता दो एवरीबडी. चलिए तो वील स्टार्ट. प्रोडक्ट ए विल ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट इन अ सेपरेट वे. प्रोडक्ट बी विल ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट इन अ सेपरेट वे. देन वील एड इट अप टू गेट द फाइनल आंसर. ओके सो दैट्स व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू बी डूइंग राइट नाउ. सो राइट डाउन प्लीज. दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन ओनली फॉर इलस्ट्रेटिव पर्पसेस. ओके सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 18. सो प्रोडक्ट ए, प्रोडक्ट बी, 16,800 will be the total answer. Okay, we know the bifurcation also. Okay, now see, we want to be finding out total material cost. Okay, so total material cost in this particular case is going to be, let's find out the cost for one unit. If you make one unit of A, that'll be requiring 8 kgs and this will be requiring 10 kgs. So therefore, I'm writing over here kgs per unit. So this is 8 kgs and this is 10 kgs. So B is obviously a heavier product, requires more materials. Now this material you are going to be purchasing from the market. So therefore into cost per kg. Cost per kg in this case, product material, 1 kg of raw material for product A costs rupees 6. So therefore this will be costing rupees 6 per kg. And this particular thing will be costing rupees 8 per kg. Direct material per unit. So if I got to be producing one unit of product A, that will be costing me how much here? 48. If I will be producing one unit of B, that is going to be costing me how much? 80. Into quantity produced. So for product A, we are going to be making 100 units. For product B, we are going to be making 150 units. So therefore, total direct material cost 4800 plus 12,000 is equal to 16,800. Now listen, now obviously the question that is going to be coming is not going to be like this. Okay, the question is going to be a different one. Now how will the question come? Imagine that in a question you are given this figure 16,800 and you are asked make separate cost sheet for product A and product B. So of course then you will require this particular bifurcation, but this bifurcation will not be given to you in the question. You will have to find out that bifurcation. Sir, how to be finding out? Obviously, those guys will give you some data. Now, how they will give you the data, that is whatever I'm trying to be saying. Now, see, if in the question, they directly give you only breakup of 16,800 is 4,800 and 12,000, then though your job is done, then I don't need to be talking also. Obviously, they will not be giving you that information. So then, now try to think, if instead of this data, even if they give you the ratio of these two numbers, that will be enough, no? If they ever tell you total direct material cost is in the ratio of 48:120, can we say giving this information is exactly same as giving the breakup only? No. You take this particular ratio and you divide it. But obviously now you are not in CA Foundation. You are not in 11th and 12th. Okay. So then what will those guys do? Those guys in this particular case will neither give you the breakup Nor in this case, those guys will give you this ratio. Okay. Instead, what those guys will start to be doing, listen to me very carefully. Instead of giving you actual informations, they will start to give you the ratios of the various informations. What does it mean? Instead of giving kgs per unit is 8 kgs and 10 kgs, they will tell you kgs per unit is in the ratio of 4:5. Okay. That is almost same as giving this particular data only. Second, they'll tell you cost per kg is in the ratio of 6:8. Either they'll give me 6:8 or they'll give me the ratio of 6:8. Even if suppose they all tell me like this, that cost per kg is in the ratio of 3:4. Okay. Giving 3:4 is exactly same as giving 6 and 8. No. Okay. So therefore they give me this particular data. Now, once they give me this particular data, I multiplied both of them. Obviously, that will be giving me this particular data. This particular data will be 12:20. Can we say this particular ratio is same as this particular ratio? No. Then further, they all will tell me quantity produced is in the ratio of 2:3. Okay, you tell me that particular thing. Giving this data is exactly same as giving the ratio of 2:3. Okay, my job is done. So therefore, my total ratio will be 24:60. Can you say 24:60? If you take 16,800, divide that in this particular ratio, the answer that will be coming is this only, no? Okay, so what is difficult in this? It is difficult because in exams, no, and the questions that will be coming, okay, what you will have to try to be thinking, listen to me very carefully now, what you will have to try to be thinking is that those guys now will tell you total direct material cost is 16,800. They will give you this particular figure, okay, and they'll tell you break it off into product A and product B. So what you got to be doing, you got to be thinking, sir, if I want to be breaking off 16,800 into this figure and this figure, I need their final ratios. I need their which ratios? Final ratios. I need their final ratios, final ratios. Okay. So what is difficult in that? You got to be thinking how this final ratio would have come. Company would have multiplied what things? Whatever company has multiplied, you try to, in this case, take the ratios and multiply the ratios, arrive at the final ratio, and then divide the total cost in that particular ratio. Understood? What did I say? Example, if suppose, those guys, in this case, give you 16,800. Okay, that is your total direct material cost. You got to be thinking, sir, total direct material cost must be multiplication of two things, sir. Which particular two things? Direct materials per unit and quantity produced. If you have the ratio of direct materials per unit, if you have the ratio of quantity produced, can we say your job is done? You take both those ratios, you multiply, and in that particular case, your job is over. If you have this particular ratio, you do not require this ratio and this ratio, no? Because direct materials per unit must be multiplication of those particular two ratios. In case you do not have this particular ratio directly in the question, okay, then you take this ratio, you multiply both these ratios, you will arrive at this particular ratio, you multiply by quantity produced, and this will start to give you total direct material cost. Is that all okay? So you got to be thinking backwards. So backward means, if suppose they give you total direct labor cost, you should be wise enough to think, sir, this total labor cost company must have got how? What things those guys must have multiplied? Whatever things those guys multiplied, you try to take the ratios and multiply, try to arrive at the final ratio, and then divide the total cost in that particular ratio. Is that all okay? Now, in the next question, that is what we are going to be doing. Next question is an intelligent question. Okay, super intelligent questions. In this question, in fact, we had the breakup. We totaled it up to find out the total amount. In the next question, you have all the total amounts, but you got to be getting breakups of them. Till the time you are going to be doing the breakups, answer are not going to be coming as such. Okay, let's do that. This is question number 10. Read, please. I love this question. Okay, read it. Messrs. Bata Shoe Company manufactures two types of shoes, that is A and B. Production cost for the year ended 31st of March are as follows. Now, these are the production cost. These are the production cost. Okay, That was hint for something that I will be asking you all. Direct materials, 15 lakhs. Tell me one thing, this 15 lakh rupees is a material incurred for type A shoes, type B shoes or total? Total. This is a combined data for the entire year. No, yaar. Okay, further, direct labor, production overheads, administration overheads. Now tell me one thing and tell me right now only. Now administration could either be administration which are related to production or it could be general administration also. In this question, it will matter because there are stocks. Okay, that will be coming in the further part of the question, but I am telling you all in advance. I'll tell you first only. Chalo. Production during the year was for A 40,000 pairs. Of which 36,000 were sold. Okay. Can we say if something was produced and something different was sold, means there are stocks, no, in the question? Okay. So there are stocks. If there are stocks, format of cost sheet will matter, no, in that case? Okay. So I got to be asking you all, tell me these administration overheads are administration related to production or general administration or, sir, we don't come to know, hence we will make an assumption, sir. Okay. Tell me which one of these three is correct. General administration. Obviously, nonsense answer because it is given to you above. I underlined also, you stupid people. I underlined also. Please speak, shout on top of your voice. Which are these particular costs? Production cost. So, therefore, this must be administration related to production. No. Now, if that is not clear, some will give you another hint also. That hint, I am not trying to be giving you all. One more hint will be coming from the question that you will have to try to tell me where is that particular hint. I am just reading the question, but there is one more hint in the question. Okay, read. Direct, it is a, sorry. There was no WIP stock at the beginning or end of the year. It is asserted that direct material in type A shoes consists twice as much as in type B shoes. Direct wages for type B shoes were 60% of those of type A shoes. Production overheads was same per pair for A and B. Okay. Administration overheads were considered to vary with direct wages. Production during the year, A 40,000 pairs, of which 36,000 were sold. Production of B 120,000 pairs, of which 1 lakh was sold. Okay. Selling cost was 1.5 per pair. Selling cost was 1.5 per pair. Obviously, this is your S&D. And lastly, this was selling cost. Now, this is selling price. Selling price was 44 for type A shoes and 28 per pair for type B shoes. Prepare a statement showing cost and profit. Okay. Tell me, there was one other hint in the question that administration are related to production. Tell me, where was that particular hint?
Point D.
Administration overheads are considered to vary with direct wages. Admin is varying with direct wages. Tell me one thing, direct wages is dependent upon production or sales?
Production.
And if administration is dependent upon direct wages and direct wages is dependent upon production, means even this admin is dependent upon production ultimately.
Yes, sir.
So that is enough hint for you all that in this particular case, this administration is related to production. It will matter because there will be stocks in this question. Acha, tell me one thing, for type A shoes, what was your quantity produced? 40. Whenever we start any question, I require quantity produced and I require quantity sold. Okay. So therefore, in this particular case, quantity produced 40,000. Now, out of 40,000, how much was sold?
36.
And can we say in the entire question, there is no opening stock of finished goods, no? But can we say there will be closing stock of 4,000 pairs, no?
Yes, sir.
How did 4,000 come? 40,000 minus 36,000. Can we say exactly the same particular reason in this case? For type B shoes, the closing stock will be 20,000 pairs, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. We are trying to be making our cost sheet as such. Okay. Now, cost sheet, see. Obviously, stocks are given product A-wise and B-wise. So, I will want separate cost for A. I will require separate cost for B. Because stock of A will get valued at cost to product A. Stock of B will get valued at cost of product B. So therefore, I require separate cost sheets as such. Just wait for a second, please. Okay, wait for a minute, not second. Listen. So in this case, I'm going to be writing cost sheet. Please don't write for the year ended 31st of March. You have type A, you have type B, and then you have total over here. Okay. I'm writing over here that I have written in all the questions till now. Quantity produced of finished goods. This is quantity sold of finished goods. Okay, please wait, please wait. 40,000, of which 36,000 was sold. 1,20,000, of which 1,00,000 was sold. In type A, I'm going to be having two columns, total per unit. In type B, I'm going to be having two columns, total and per unit. And total is just total of product A and product B. Okay, wait. First of all, if we start our cost sheet, there is direct material. Tell me in this question, direct material is how much? 15 lakhs. Now that figure obviously is the total of the entire company. Tell me where should I write it? In the last column. So therefore 15 lakhs. Okay. Same way in this particular case, you will have direct labor. Direct labor 8,40,000. The moment you total it up, this will start to give you prime cost 23,40,000. Please don't write. Add in this case your factory overheads. Factory overheads in the question is 3,60,000. Now there is no WIP stock. If there is no WIP stock, this will become factory cost for you. So therefore, factory cost is 27 lakhs. Now listen. Add. Tell me what comes after factory cost. Administration related to production. So therefore, administration related to production. Now, administration related to production in this particular case is 12,60,000. Okay. Once you all do that, this will start to give you your COP. COP is going to be 39,60,000. Okay. After that, add opening stock of finished goods, which is not even there also. Less closing stock of finished goods. Now, closing stock of finished goods, if you all remember, we used to be writing the quantity also. So, closing stock of finished goods for product A, it is 4,000. For product B, it is nothing but 20,000. Now, that we all will try to value. Okay, that we all will see at a later on stage. Okay, once this particular thing is done, this will start to give you cost of sales. Now, cost of sales add... No, this will start to give you cost of goods sold. Sorry. Then after that, obviously add S&D overheads. There is no general admin in this question. This will start to give you cost of sales. Add profit, get sales over here. This will be your format of cost sheet, obviously, for this particular question. Okay. Now, listen. Once this particular thing is done, listen. Few easy things I'm trying to finish it off. Okay, you all don't write, just help me. Adjustment number F. Selling cost was 1.5 per pair. Can we say it was 1.5 per pair if that line is given? That line is applicable to type A and type B both, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so therefore 1.5 per pair, 1.5 per pair. Tell me to arrive at the total figure. Should I multiply by quantity produced or quantity sold? Quantity sold. So quantity sold is over here. So multiply 1.5 by 36,000, multiply 1.5 by 1,00,000. You'll get this answer, you'll get this particular answer. Total it up. Okay. So that particular thing will happen. Further, I'm reading adjustment number G also. Selling price was 44 for type A and 28 for type B. So therefore, 44 over here. This particular thing was 28. Okay. The moment you all do this particular thing, then in that case, your sales will also be done. Okay, this is a selling price. You tell me to arrive at the total sales, you will multiply by quantity produced or quantity sold? Quantity sold. Okay, so wherever there is a tick, those numbers also you are completing. Rest, whatever I have left blank, please leave it blank only for the timing. We will see that in just a while. Okay, you all have given the title cost sheet for. You all give the title, please. So in case you all have not given, cost sheet for the year ending 31st of March. And you all make this cost sheet, then we all will start, please. Make it in a neat manner, please. Once it is done, do let me know, please. Just a sec. Okay, listen. Now see. I'm going to be asking you all something. The moment I ask, I know you will reply. I know what you will reply. But hold on for some time before you will reply finally. What I want from you all, read adjustment number A, adjustment number B, and adjustment number C, ABC. Read these three. And I want the breakup of 15 lakhs, 8 lakhs, and 3 lakhs 60 into these particular figures. Okay, I want that breakup. Okay, now this. I did one complete question and I explained you something over there. That explanation you will have to try to recall. In any case, you have the things, few of the things in the notebooks also for question number 18. So, do not reply instantaneously. Think whatever I told you all. Okay. I gave you in all 4 minutes for cracking these three breakups. Okay. Think coolly. Think wisely. Your 4 minutes start now. Don't be in a hurry to reply. I'll give you 5 minutes because you'll have to be thinking a lot. Believe me, the first answer that you might have thought is all wrong only. Okay. Think properly what I had explained you and implement that and then try to tell me the breakup of material, labor and factory overheads. That is the only thing left in this particular question. Rest, it is a procedure of the cost sheet that will try to ensure that everything is correct only. Okay. So you all have 5 minutes. Time starts now. Do not reply before 4 minutes. Your answer will be wrong. 100%. Okay. So, reply after 4 minutes but before 5 minutes. So if somebody has got the answer, you all can try to tell me for materials. You tell me for materials, I'll understand your thinking as such. I want the breakup for materials, please.
6 lakhs and 9 lakhs.
6 lakhs. 10 lakhs and 5 lakhs. If it was 10 lakhs and 5 lakhs only, what was there to think so much? 30 seconds are still left. So those guys are saying 10 lakhs and 5 lakhs. And tell me the breakup of direct wages also, please.
5 lakhs, 5,000,
3 lakhs. Okay. Yes. And lastly, tell me also the breakup then for production overheads.
90,000 and 270,000.
Okay. Okay, listen. Now, I'm going to be reading out one line. I'm going to be giving you all two options. Tell me what came to your mind. I've understood your thinking at least of most of the people. Okay, few people have replied correct, but those people don't know that it is correct or it is not correct. Okay, listen. Direct material in type A shoes consists twice as much as in type B shoes. Now, that much English everybody understands. But what I am asking you all is something different. When you read this particular line, direct material in type A shoes consists twice as much as in type B shoes. Okay. What came to your mind? I am giving you two options. First, sir, whatever material goes in making one pair of A and one pair of B of type A and type B. Okay. Sir, the amount of material that goes in one pair of A is twice that of B. Did this come to your mind? Okay. Means that 2:1 is per pair. Or no, sir. Whatever you are saying is all nonsense. Sir, this is the total ratio. Total ratio means that whatever quantity was produced in this entire year, okay, type A material consumed double as compared to type B shoes. Okay, means this ratio of 2:1 that is given to you over here, is it per unit ratio or is it total ratio? Now, obviously somebody can ask me, sir, why are you asking us these particular questions? I'm asking you because of one reason. See, don't write, just pay attention. Material cost. You have type A, you have type B. My total material cost is 15 lakh rupees. That is for sure. Okay, that cannot be denied. That 2:1 is what? Some people can be saying, sir, that is the information for one unit of type A shoes and one unit of type B shoes. If you all say this, so that means this ratio is 2:1. But you do not want this particular ratio. What ratio you want is nothing but total direct material cost ratio. Okay. Tell me one thing. This is direct materials per unit. To reach from direct material cost per unit to total direct material cost, you multiply by quantity produced or quantity sold?
Quantity produced.
So therefore, quantity produced. Can you say quantity produced is in the ratio of 1:3? No.
Yes, sir.
Quantity produced is in the ratio of 1:3. No, 40,000:1,20,000. Correct? No, everybody?
Yes, sir.
So, therefore, this particular thing is 1:3. So, final ratio will be 2:3. Are you saying this? Sir, that 2:1 was per unit ratio. But, sir, we want the breakup of 15 lakhs. 15 lakhs is total direct material cost. So, sir, from here, we got to be reaching till here, sir. And obviously, we got to be multiplying by quantity produced in middle. Once we all multiply, sir, total direct material cost will be in what ratio? 2:3. Are you saying this, that this will be the answer? If you are going to be saying this is going to be your answer, then 15 lakh rupees will be divided in the ratio of 2:3. This is option number one. Okay. Somebody can be saying, what nonsense, sir. Okay. You explained any rubbish. Sir, that 2:1, no, is directly this particular ratio only. Okay. Now, if you all say 2:1 is directly this particular ratio only, then 15 lakhs you directly divide in the ratio of 2:1. You all understood the two options?
Yes, sir.
You all understood that answer will be different under both the cases, no? Now you all tell me, just read the line once more. Tell me which ratio is 2:1. Is it per unit ratio or is it the total ratio? What ratio is 2:1? Read this sentence 5 times in your mind. Recap your entire cost sheet that you all have done. I have told this particular logic somewhere also. In fact, in yesterday's lecture. But then you all try to tell me that 2:1 is which ratio? Per unit ratio or total ratio? Now be careful if you are going to be replying to me any answer, which you all should reply. I will ask you the logic, how do you know? Okay, because that is whatever matters to me as such. Okay, else you can get it correct by fluke also, yaar. Tell me now and speak up, please. Speak up, please. You know, most of the CAs know. Most of the CAs who all become CAs also. They are only good in studies and nothing else. They can't speak anything. Okay. So, whenever you are asked to speak something, ensure that you all speak. That will give you good confidence. If you are wrong, it will make you remember that you were wrong somewhere. Okay. If you were right, that will give you good confidence that you think correct. Last time. Is that speak up? Speak up, everybody. Tell me, is that total ratio or per unit ratio? One person who is ready to tell me, sir, it is total ratio, and sir, I know this because. Muhammad, tell me, how do you know it is total ratio? Bol.
Sir, because
unit. Acha, nothing is told about units, so therefore it must be the total ratio. Good point. Okay. Aryan, how do you know it is per unit ratio?
Sir, matlab aise logically if we see then per unit for matlab type mein hum log hum log ke paas 14,000 produce kiye to fir agar hum log total pe lenge to ratio 10 lakhs is to 5 lakhs wo matlab kaise hota hai.
That is not the logic. You are trying to see by the results that the results will be very awkward. It can happen, no? Type A shoes are XL size. It will require more material. That can happen, no?
Yes.
Type A shoes are made for elephants. Then it can happen, no?
Yes, sir.
So it's okay. So don't see based upon the results. Give me some logic. Viral. Logic, 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 logic. Yeah, Rohan.
Sir, I think it's per unit because it's written like A should consist twice as much. So it's not talking about grass, about total. It's saying about one thing that for one shoe, if you produce for B, this much material required, then twice of that material is required to produce one shoe of type A.
99% it is all correct. Okay, see. As he told, I'm speaking exactly the same words that he had used also. Whenever you read this particular line, no, direct material in type A shoes consists twice as much as in type B shoes. This is a general line that is given to you. Whereby those guys are saying whatever material goes in type A, that is double as compared to B. So whenever they are speaking this particular sentence, they must be talking of one unit only, boss. And if that is not a convincing reason, then I'll tell you only one reason, which I spoke of yesterday in our first question also. It is direct material. Direct material and direct labor, whatever information they will give you will always be per unit, no, by default. Yesterday we all did that in one of the questions whereby we increased the figures by 10%. You all remember? And nobody needs to be telling me this thing because these are direct costs. Direct cost means they are directly incurred for each and every unit. So therefore, in this case, that 2:1 in this particular case is nothing but the ratio of, I'm asking for the last time, per unit or total?
Per unit.
And last time, how do you know that particular thing?
Because it is a direct cost.
And if that explanation is not okay, if you will rationally read this particular line, no, Direct material in type A shoes consists twice as much as direct material in type B shoes. If I make one pair of A, if I make one pair of B, I think this line tells me that direct material in A will be twice that of B. Obviously, I'm trying to talk of one pair only, boss. Okay, so therefore, in this particular case, this ratio is going to be 2:1. Quantity produced obviously is 40,000 is to 120,000, that is 2:3. Okay, just a sec. That is 1:3, no? 1:3. So therefore, your total direct material cost is going to be 2:3. Okay, this will be your material cost. Now just wait. Whatever you write over here, no? Whatever you write over here, okay. 15 lakhs, let's divide it up in the ratio of 2:3. You all do not do that. Just help me to achieve something. If I divide 15 lakhs in the ratio of 2:3, can you say over here what will be coming is 6 lakhs? Over here, what will be coming over here is nothing but 9 lakhs. So that's okay for everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you pick up your calci, divide 6 lakhs by quantity produced, please.
15.
And over there, 9 lakhs by 1,20,000?
7.5.
So now see, whatever we have written there will get proved over here also. Okay. Total cost is in the ratio of 2:3. Obviously, total cost is in the ratio of 2:3. Obviously. Okay. Second. Per unit cost is in the ratio of 2:1. So, per unit cost is in the ratio of 2:1. You can see both those things over here. If for any reason somebody thinks, sir, we don't want to be doing by this way. Okay, you can make an equation and then you can be doing that. But even if you are going to be making the equation, no? Okay, please define your things in a proper way. This 2 and this 1 are per unit cost. Okay, just wait. This thing you all might be doing, might not be doing. That's your call. Let direct material cost per unit for type A shoes be 2x. Therefore, type B will be x. Is this all okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. Now tell me, should I be stupid enough to make an equation 2x plus x is equal to 15 lakhs?
No, sir.
No. Beta, 2x is per unit cost. 15 lakhs is total cost. No. So, therefore, my equation will be, please pick up the equation. 2x is direct material cost for A. Tell me into? Into 40,000. No. This will give you total direct material cost for product A. Is that all okay?
Yes.
Okay. Plus, the other one will be x into, speak further.
1,20,000.
Okay. The moment you all will be doing that, can you say this is material cost for A, this is material cost for B, you will total it up, this particular figure will be coming to 15 lakhs, no? Okay. So therefore, this will be 80,000x, this will be 1,20,000x, this will be 15 lakhs as such. Okay. So therefore, this will be 2,00,000x is equal to 15 lakhs. Once you all do that, x will be equal to 7.5. And 2x in this particular case will be equal to 15. Ultimately, you will be getting the same answer. So, 2x means direct material cost per unit for A, no?
Yes, sir.
So, therefore, your 15 rupees will be coming over here. Okay, your 7.5 will be coming over here. Then you can multiply by quantity produced to arrive at the answers. Is that all okay for everybody?
Yes, sir.
Now, all the other things I'm not going to be doing by two methods. I will only do by that particular ratio method. You are not writing anything. Pay attention because in end, I'll tell you all to finish off the entire question. Okay, direct labor. Now, you have understood one thing correctly. So, please answer all other things in a proper way. Okay, second. Direct wages in type B shoes were 60% of those of type A shoes. So, therefore, there is some ratio is that is 100:60. Okay. You all understood this?
Yes, sir.
Tell me this ratio is per unit ratio or total ratio?
Per unit.
How do you know that?
Because
it is direct cost. Okay. So, therefore, direct labor per unit is in the ratio of 100:60. Okay. obviously, but that 840,000 rupees is total cost, no yaar. Okay, so therefore, from direct labor per unit, you have to try to reach the total direct labor cost. Tell me, you will multiply by what?
1:3.
Quantity produced, that is 1:3. Okay, once you all do that, your final cost will be 100:180. So obviously, in this particular case, 840,000 rupees will get divided in this particular ratio. The moment you all do that, in your cost sheet, your this particular breakup of direct labor will also be over. Okay, find out the per unit figures. You will be reaching till prime cost. Okay, once you all reach till prime cost, then factory overheads. Now factory overheads is supposed to be the easiest part of this entire question. This is working note 2, this is working note 3 now. So therefore, factory overheads, read your adjustment number C. Adjustment number C tells you production overheads, means factory overheads, was same. Please shout and tell me same. Further, what is written? Same
per pair
for A and B. Can we say instructions are very clear that 1:1 ratio is per pair? No. Okay, but this 360,000 is total cost, no, as such. Okay, so therefore I'm writing exactly the same particular thing. This is factory overheads per unit or per pair, that is in the ratio of 1:1. But I want to be reaching till total factory overheads, because that 360,000 rupees is total factory overheads. Okay, so therefore multiply this particular thing by some quantity. You tell me with what quantity to multiply.
Quantity
produced. Please do remember, these are factory overheads, hence I am multiplying by quantity produced. If this was S&D, no, I would like to multiply by
quantity sold.
Okay, so therefore in this case it is still 1:3 only. So therefore 360,000 rupees, please divide in the ratio of 1:3. The moment you all will be doing that particular thing, okay, so factory overheads will also be coming. Then factory cost will also be coming. Okay, once your factory overheads will come, factory cost will also be coming. Okay, for admin, which are related to production, no brains are to be used. See what is given to you over here. Administration overheads are considered to vary with, please speak further,
direct
wages. So means admin is related to direct wages. So whatever ratio was applicable for direct wages will be applicable for admin also, because admin is related to wages. Is that okay? So your direct labor ratio in this particular case was how much? Yaar, 100:180. So therefore administration ratio will also be 100:180. Okay, that is same as your direct labor cost. Okay, now once you all do this, your this particular job will also be done. COP in this case you all will reach. Now there is no opening stock of finished goods. Tell me one thing, whenever you have to value your closing stock, can we say we always value closing stock at cost of production? In the first three questions we exactly did that particular thing, no?
Yes, sir.
Now tell me, by default we follow which particular method?
FIFO
method. Now please remember your first two lectures. Can we say this figure will get copied over here?
Yes.
Okay, and we will multiply by 4000 units. Okay, that will give you closing stock of finished goods. Okay, once you all do that, subtract this and subtract this, you will start to arrive at COGS. Tell me one thing, from COGS onwards, you always divide by which quantity to get the per unit figure?
Quantity
sold. Okay, exactly the same thing for this also. Your closing stock will get valued at current cost of production. You subtract this particular thing over here, COGS will come. COGS, please divide by quantity sold of product B, this particular thing will come. This plus this will be giving you this. Same way in this particular case, this plus this would have given you this particular figure. Okay, once you all do that, only calculations will be left and nothing else. Okay, you have your S&D, you will arrive at your cost of sales. You have your sales, profits are going to be your balancing figure. Is that understood? What work you have to be doing?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Copy down your working notes. I'm showing you all the things. Okay. And then in all, you have 15 minutes to be completing this entire question head to tail, completely by yourself. Okay. You all will start now. I'll keep on scrolling once your working note 1 is all done. Once your material is done, please do let me know. You all have 14 minutes left. Complete these notes, then start away with the cost sheet, please.
This figure must be 36. Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
This figure must be 21. So your valuation in this case will happen at 36 and 21. 36 into 4,000, 1,44,000. 4,20,000. This figure must be 2,34,000. You all have finished?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, I'm going to be asking you all one question. Everybody has finished. You all have finished, no? Sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, reply to me one question. This question is open to everybody. This is the first question where this figure, and this figure has all, have all come same only. You all can check in your previous questions. Like this and this are always same only because this 36, we pick it up from here only. Yeah? Okay. But in this question, even this particular number is same only. This is cost of goods sold. Tell me, why did this particular thing happen? In your other questions, it never happened. In this question, it happened. This figure, 12,96,000, when you divided by 36,000, it came to 36.
Because opening stock was not there.
If you all try to think rationally, tell me what is the full form of this? What is the full form of this? Cost of goods sold. Can we say you all have produced, 40,000 pairs, okay, and every pair has a cost of 36. Out of that only 4,000 pairs are not sold, so obviously they will be having cost of 36. Can we say out of that 40,000, if 4,000 pairs are not sold, that means 36,000 pairs are sold? But 36,000 will also have a cost of 36 only, no? This thing has happened because there was no opening stock. Ek minute, I'm just asking, did you all realize what I asked at least? If there is no opening stock, can you say whatever is not sold, that is also out of the production? And whatever is sold, that is also out of the production of current year. And current year's production cost is 36, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you all have understood. So let me now ask you the better question. This coincidence, okay, or this thing can only happen in two cases in this world. First, that either there is no opening stock of finished goods, like in this particular question, or even if there is opening stock of finished goods, continue.
the cost was same for producing that goods also.
That opening stock cost, even if opening stock was there, even if its cost was 36, no, then also this particular cost ultimately will come to 36 only. Understood everybody?
Yes, sir.
If you all have not, then just last time I'm trying my heart out. Okay. In this case, this is might be question number one that we all had done. So therefore, a trading account kind of a thing. I produced 40,000 pairs at cost of 36. So therefore, this was 14,40,000, I think. Okay. Out of that, how much is sold? 36,000. How much is not sold? 4,000. Can we say whatever is not sold, that is also out of this only? Whatever is sold, that is also out of this only. Can you say this particular figure itself is nothing but your COGS? No.
Yes.
Cost of the goods that you all have sold in this particular year. Okay. Now, what I have written in the shorts that I'm trying to be reading once. For direct material and direct labor information given will always be for one unit unless or until specified. So, therefore, that data is for one unit because it is a direct cost. For overheads, they will always mention whether the information given is per unit or total. Like for factory overheads, you all mentioned, no, that it was same per pair. Whenever there are two products, prepare cost sheet product wise, like in this particular question. If any problem, valuation of opening stock of finished goods is not given. Not applicable in this question. Then assume last year's COP to be same as current year's cost of production. Now, what does that particular thing mean? Example, if in this question, no, opening stock quantity was there, but its value was not there. Recall your first two or three questions. Opening stock of finished goods was always given to you. Opening stock quantity was also given, amounts were also given. But if in any question quantities are given but amounts are not given, then you all can assume that current year's cost of production is applicable to last year also. Means suppose in this question opening stock of finished goods was given as 1000 units, okay, but the amount was not given, okay. So then you can assume that opening stock rate for type A is also 36. But that will be an assumption that you'll have to be writing separately. That as value of opening stock is not given, we assume the value at the rate of 36 per unit. That is same as current year's cost of production. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
That is for some other question that might be there in future. Not applicable to this particular question. Okay, further. As administration overheads are considered to vary with direct wages, they must be administration related to production. Okay, that's it. Okay. Now, this question is altogether done. Okay, from our side completely. Okay. For overheads, they will always clarify in a proper way whether the information is per unit or total. Else you cannot solve the question. So you cannot ask me a question like this, that if suppose the information is not clear, they want you all to solve the question. So for production overheads, they will always tell you. If this was a line, no, production overheads was same for A and B. Okay. If this was a line, then I cannot tell you what is to be done. Okay. You put forward an assumption and then you all try to be solving. Okay. But 99% at least at CA inter level, they will give you for overheads whether the information is per unit or total. They will have to give you, else you cannot be solving. Because else each and everybody might start to have a different category of answers, which I say will not want also. Okay. This is altogether done. Now, at the end of each and every chapter, we are going to be having a test. At the end of each and every chapter, okay, and you do not require any prior notice for it, please. Okay, rules of the test, you're going to be starting from the last page of your notebook to answer that particular test. Okay, for every chapter there will be a test, so ensure that you are going to be doing that. Okay, first, second, once you attempt your test, there will be a timer that will come on the screen also. Okay, so you see that particular question within the time you all solve. The moment you all finish, or the moment the time is finished, the earliest of the two, you will stop. You will be getting a self-assessment kind of a solution from our side, which tells you if this is correct, how many marks, if this is correct, how many marks, and so on. Okay. See that solution completely and give yourself the marks. Once you have given, you click a photograph and send us the paper as well as the marks on a Telegram ID, that is @AJNext. Okay. So therefore, we are starting with the test of cost sheet. I don't want to be giving any preparation time or something like this ever. Okay. We all have solved the chapter. This is the best time that you all are prepared as such. Okay. So we are just starting. And in case you do not give, then I do not reply to your further doubts on Telegram. Okay. So it is quid pro quo that you all have learned in law. You all have learned this term quid pro quo.
Yes, sir.
You do something for me, I will do something for you. Okay. This test you are starting. You are going to be getting 30 minutes from our side to be doing this. Good question on cost sheet. Your 30 minutes are starting right now for reading and for solving the complete thing. Okay. So 30 minutes are starting right now. In 30 minutes, the timer will buzz. Okay. And then you all will stop. Once you all get the self-assessment paper, then in that case, you try to send me how many marks you all have got with the photo of your answer paper. Write neatly, okay? And these things, if you all will do towards the end, costing will obviously become your best subject. Okay, let's start. Any assumption should be forming part of the answer, if there will be an assumption. Thank you. case you complete early, then it is all fine. Else 18 minutes are left for you all to be completing. Yes. At the rate okay. AJ next.
Okay, sir.
Okay. चलिए गाइस, सो योर टाइम इज ऑल ओवर. इट वॉज वन ऑफ द वेरी गुड क्वेश्चंस ऑन कॉस्टिंग. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट टाइम आई विल सी ऑल विद अ न्यू चैप्टर एंड वील कैच अप सून. ओके, तो चलो बाय.